Welcome to ATV Television, the original television program for ATV enthusiasts and adventurers. Are you driving around in a naked rhino? Well, strong up and ride. It's easy with a full line of great products by J. Strong Industries. Windshields, doors, consoles, bumpers, battery isolators, and even tops complete with lights and stereo systems. J. Strong products are designed to work and constructed with only the highest quality materials. Ask for J. Strong products at your local dealer or visit their website to find a dealer near you. J. Strong Industries. Strong up and ride.
Terra Firma just got tamed. Introducing the TerraCross radio from ITP. It's built for maximum traction on hard-packed trails. The radial design gives you a smooth ride over any kind of terrain. Call for a free catalog or visit itptires.com.
Kawasaki mules have been around for a long, long time. In fact, it was the mule that started this whole utility vehicle thing long before it was popular. And mules have been used for years around farms and construction sites where the requirement was to move men and equipment around the area rather than just provide fun for the operator. Now, when we last compared the Kawasaki mule, the Yamaha Rhino, and the Polaris Ranger, we made the comment that where the Rhino is made for fun, the mule is made for work. Because of this, they're designed as sturdy, reliable workhorses. That means industrial engines and steel construction. Although the Transcab is a new model, it's still based on the proven and somewhat dated technology and construction of the past models. Mules are available in both two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive models, but because our requirements consist of varied terrain, our test models are four-wheel drive. Now, prices for the Mule 3000 series starts at $74.99 for the regular cab two-wheel drive and goes up to the Transcab in gas power at $99.99, and the Transcab with diesel power goes for $10,799. But first, let's take a look at what makes the Transcab what it is. It's built on an 85.2-inch wheelbase. That's 11.5 inches longer than the standard cab 3010 Mule. Now, that extra length results in a cab that's long enough to fit in an extra seat. So, now in Transcab form, the Mule can easily carry four adults. Although, there's not enough room in either seat to really let a six-footer stretch out. Its intention is to carry these guys from one part of a job site to another, not take them across country on a sightseeing vacation. The unique part of the Transcab, and the reason for its name, is that in just a couple of minutes, the rear seat can be folded forward and the Mule transformed from a four-seat short bed configuration into a two-seat long bed setup, and then just as quickly, back again. One of the most noticeable changes to all mules, at least to someone like me that's had a mule around the ranch here for years, is that the tailgate and all movable points like the bed swivel extensions and headache rack are now mounted in rubber bushings to help to keep the rattles down on rough and washboarded surfaces. While a gas mule is powered by a 617cc V-twin two-cylinder engine, the diesel mule is powered by a 950cc three-cylinder. The gas model's power seems adequate, but the liquid-cooled diesel is amazing. It has 38.3 foot-pounds of torque at 2,800 RPM, and that gives the mule the ability to pull like you won't believe. All mules put their power to the ground through a continuously variable transmission with high range, low range, neutral, and reverse. Now there's one knob on the dash to select either two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive, and another that allows the rear differential to be either open or locked. The big advantage to the rear locker, unlocker, is that in unlocked mode, the action of the differential allows the rear tires to turn at different speeds so they don't tear up the dirt, turf, or whatever the surface that you're operating on. And if you need more traction for muddy, slippery, or off-road excursions, just move the knob, lock in the differential, and voila! The rear works just like the rear of an ATV. climbing, and you'll find the seating comfortable, although a bit harder to get into or out of than the standard cab versions. To start the diesel engine, you must turn on the key and wait for the glow plug light to go out. But since the mule still requires that the transmission be in neutral to start, by the time you remember to do that, the light has gone out and the engine is ready to start. One of the strong points of the gas mules is how quiet they are. That is not the case with the diesel, as it's a rather crude engine that rattles and vibrates a lot. But like a good diesel, there's so much torque that it feels like the only thing that'll stop this mule is a lack of traction. It's absolutely amazing. Now, the limited suspension travel works well for slow and smooth going, but it's not well suited for sporty fun. And the engine is governed at around 25 miles an hour, just in case you wanted to anyways. But trust me, you wouldn't. All the operations are easy enough, and the transmission shifts between low, high, forward, and reverse without any hesitation or clunks. The two-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, and locker knobs slide from one position to another without complaint. The steering doesn't require a construction worker to operate, and best of all, the parking brake is a handy, hand lever just to the driver's left. Although the mule is equipped with a dump bed, trying to get it to dump with anything in it other than, say, one small shovel of dry manure is best left to the hired hand. You see, the hinge point is located too far to the rear of the bed, so if you need to use the dumping capability of the mule, you might want to plan on getting an electric lift system for the bed. So, where the gas engine mule is cheaper, smoother running, and quieter, the diesel is rougher, louder, but with enough torque to make you not really care about it, smoother and quieter. The good? Sturdy, steel construction, proven reliability, torquey diesel, smooth running gas, and that handbrake. The bad? Doesn't start in gear, the dump needs assist, and it's a long, long rig to drive and turn around. The bottom line? If you really need a real utility vehicle to haul four people around your work site or hunting lease, and you're not in a hurry, this is the perfect rig.
You want to ride the Screaming Aardvark Trail this weekend?
You're on! I gotta eat some gear though.
Yeah, me too. Hey, I'll see you then. Oh, cool.
What?
Yeah, I need a shot. So if I add the boots, shipping's free?
The shipping's free.
Excellent.
Oh, yes.
Here's a package, sir.
Oh, yeah!
My boots!
Nice!
You look good.
Shut up.
Get ready the easy way with Rocky Mountain.
When you really use your ATV, you can depend on Quad Boss. Whether you need to get through a tough week of work or get through a weekend of rugged exploration, you can depend on Quad Boss. Quad Boss has the accessories you need to get the most out of your ATV. Quad Boss accessories are available at your local ATV retailer and accessory store. Ask for Quad Boss. You can depend on us.
If you want more information on the products, ATVs, or adventures featured in today's show, make sure you check out our website at atvtv.com.